Welcome back. Let's summarize what we've learned about DFAR 7012, 7019, and 7020. The Defense Federal Acquisition Regulation Supplement is the DoD's supplement to the Federal Acquisition Regulation. As of today, there are about 30 agency supplements to the FAR. The DFARS provides DoD-specific acquisition regulations. DFAR 7012 describes the protection requirements for non-federal systems that process, store, or transmit CUI. 7012 requires the implementation of NIST 800-171. It requires the contractor to self-attest that they are compliant. It also requires that contractor cloud systems that contain CUI meet security requirements equivalent to the FedRAMP moderate baseline. It also establishes incident reporting requirements that also extend to cloud service providers, and it requires the prime contractors flow down the clause and its requirements to subcontractors. And yes, this means that your subs also have to implement NIST 800-171 if they are handling CUI on their systems. DFAR 7019 requires that contractors submit a NIST 800-171 score into SPRS. A score must be submitted to be considered for contract award. The score must be less than 3 years old, and the scores are calculated using DoD's assessment methodology. DFAR 7020 requires that contractors provide the government access to its facilities, systems, and personnel to conduct a medium or high assessment if necessary. 7020 defines different levels of assessments. A basic assessment is a self-assessment completed by the contractor. In a medium assessment, DIBCAC will review the contractor's SSP and its descriptions of how each requirement is met. In a high assessment, DIBCAC will perform a very thorough on-site or virtual audit that assesses the contractor's documentation and the technical implementation of NIST 800-171. Let's summarize. DFAR 7012 requires the implementation of NIST 800-171 and provides incident reporting requirements. DFAR 7019 requires the submission of an assessment score into SPRS. 7020 requires the contractor to provide the government access to facilities, systems, and personnel to facilitate medium and high assessments. That's all for this one. See you in the next one.